Hello, Blender Nation. This is a tutorial on how to use the video sequence editor in Blender 2.8 beta. Several days ago, I was experimenting with Blender 2.8 beta, trying to use that video sequencer because I use it a lot for my YouTube videos. And when I was trying to do it on my own, I had hell. It took me a long time to find the appropriate command. So I'm making this little tutorial to show you, if you love the video sequencer, to how to get up to speed and quickly make your video. All right, so first of all, if you're using, and this is only for Blender 2.8 beta, not alpha, but beta. 2.8 beta, you will see this little box up right here. This orange colored box with the arrow in it. Right beneath it, you click that little symbol, you come down, and you will see video sequencer. Or if you want to, you can type shift FB. All right, there's my sequencer. Now I'm going to add a video. No longer are your options at the bottom. All your options for the video sequence editor are at the top. So I'm going to go up here to add. I'm going to movie, and let me see what file I'm gonna load off my computer for this little bit for demonstration purposes. I'm gonna load this file right here. What happened? Nothing. All right, let me go back and choose another file. Movie play. Okay, let's see. Let me click home. Now, the next part that it took me a long time to find, I want to see my sound wave. So you got to go back up here, make one of these selections. Let me see which one it is. I choose view, select, add, frame. Which one was it? View. Yeah, you got to go to view. We go down here to where it says waveform display. Then you choose waveform on. And let's wait a little couple minutes and see what happened. Right up here, it's in there. It took me forever to find that. A long time. The next, I wanted to add some special effects. And like usual, if you want to add like sort of effects to it, effect strips right here. You click on this, you can add your effect strips. So that's pretty straightforward. But what gave me trouble, I like to use the certain strips. If I want to see that little, like in Blender 2.7, the edit strip screen is right here. Let me go back. To get that little edit strip tab, you have to click on this little plus sign and pull it out. Then with the edit strip, you can do all your edits and adjustments like you did with Blender 2.7. It took me forever to discover that plus sign. I was about 30 minutes. You can also go to your modifiers. My favorite modifier is the color balance. But you got the idea. And then when you're ready to create your movie, it's different now. It's no longer on that properties tab. You have to go back up here. Like when you render everything else in Blender, you gotta go to render. And you got to choose render animation. But this is the important part too. I try to save my CPU. So to save CPU, you got to go to right down here where it says display mode. You either can choose full screen, image editor, new window, and keep user interface. That's my favorite. Keep user interface to save CPU power. GPU on my computer. So I hope everyone, but by me giving this little brief introduction of the video sequencer, you can be able to jump right into Blender 2.8 beta or the official release that's said to be coming out sometime in June 2.8. The most important tab you need to worry about is over here, this little plus sign tab. And this make everything look the way it looked in Blender 2.7. You got your edit strip, you have your strip input, filters, you have your proxies, etc. This is exactly how that strip looked in Blender 2.7. You just have to go searching for it on Blender 2.8. So, thank you for stopping by. If I was helpful to you and giving you information about how to use the video sequencer in Blender 2.8, give me a thumbs up, please. If you have any little comments you want to add to give me some new ideas, because I'm still new to Blender 2.8 beta myself, to give me ideas on how to find certain things, please give me your input. And then also, before we go, no longer is your information right in the center. Those numbers, they are to the far right, but that's self-explanatory. You will see that as you go. So anyway, I hope this helped you. You all have a wonderful day. Leave a comment. Please give me a thumbs up. Ciao.